hours, and if you don't work, there are things that you will be able to pay for and afford.
Yeah.
Can't come back home, I imagine, things like that, okay? So, we're gonna do a quick story, right? And what's gonna happen is, you're gonna come in, and you're gonna, you know, talk to him about his grades and what's going on, why is he setting up, right? And then you're gonna come in, and you're gonna, you know, talk to him about, like, what's going on. And I want you to interact with both of them. You're gonna interact with him. Usually, for foreign theater, we come up with like a script, right? There's like a script in the very beginning, and then we stop. So we're gonna improvise the script, and then the second time around, we'll know what to do, okay? So, ready? All right, step out. Where are you gonna be? Where's the setting? You stand in the chair, but where are we?
We're in school, y'all.
Yeah, in the classroom. Yeah. Yeah, that makes sense. That makes sense. Okay. Ready?
Well, maybe in a store. In a store. And he's working out.
So first in the classroom, because he's going to come in first, and then, I don't know, we're going to, like, you move to the store. Ready? 3, 2, 1, and come on.
Hey, Joel.
How are you doing?
I'm doing great. I'm glad that you're in the class, and I talked to you for a reason. I see your grades, and... Well, I don't, how do I say this without disappointing? I'm worried studying for disappointing. What's going on? I've seen your grades lately, and I see that it's not close to going to. Well, what do you want to do with it? What do you want to do after school when you graduate? What do you want to do?
After I graduate?
Yeah.
I mean, hopefully, after I attend your classes, hopefully, if I do well, I'm not going to go on to medical school. Is that a possibility right now? I'm not sure.
Well, I've seen your tests, and they're not above 70. Something tells me you're not studying, and, well, you know, medical school is urgent to get in. In order to get in, you must do very well. I mean, I don't know what you're doing outside of class, but hopefully you're hitting those books. The reason why we told you about it, well, besides Christ, you know, well, it stops lives. I made it clearly, and I made my criteria clear, too. And well, everyone's doing well. I mean, I see people getting A's and not 12, but even 100%. And I see yours, it's not close to them. I'm very sorry to tell you this, but I'm just very concerned about this because I want you to do very well.
Okay, so now, you want to go to school? Go ahead. So now, Joelle, I want you to agree to study and you're going to start studying, okay?
So I suggest you to hit the books extremely hard, like every day. I mean, I'm saying I'm stuck, but when you get a time to study, you make that imagine. Clear, you want to pass this class.
Yeah, I understand what you're saying. I mean, I can't really give you an excuse. I mean, I do have other responsibilities, but I will make a more concerted effort to put more time into my studies. If that means I have to make more time, you know, maybe sleeping less, I'll do it. I'm
okay. So thank you. Now he's gonna do what you want, right? Okay, boom. So now I want you to start studying. You're studying where you, so now, okay, so you're going to be studying at work. Okay, next scene is you're going to study at work. So now, go ahead and study at work. Ready, and go. Joel, what are you doing?
I'm studying for my...
Okay, that's great, and I know you want to better yourself, but you owe my time.
Yes.
And owe my time, you work. You hear me? So put that away. Do you want your hours cut?
No.
Okay. Okay. Perfect. That's great. So, hit the machine, because I am not doing this for you. And last night, you come, and the register was wrong. Like, I'm not dealing with this. All right? Mm-hmm. All right. So, what are you going to do? Do you want hours, or do you not want more hours?
I definitely want the hours that I still have.
Okay, great. All right, so, this nonsense, on my time, it's done. All right? So, have a good day. And I'm going to be checking the cameras because you wouldn't work. So you're going to do what I say. All right? All right. Right? Got that down. Okay, so
we're gonna look at Joel as the protagonist, right? His story is the protagonist. Repitan. And now, the compañeros that are representing the things he needs to balance, right, time management, are the antagonists. Repitan. Right? So we want to root for the protagonist, right? We want the protagonist to do a good job. However, there are the things that are antagonizing him. These are just two of the things kind of splitting him apart. Now, you ready for the next part? First of all, I'm going to do a little theater recommendation. We're going to now speak nice and loud because that was the improv, but I feel like that works. For the second round, let's cut the conversations so that you basically are getting to the meat. You're not studying, da-da-da-da. It's time management. What are you going to do? Okay, I'm gonna do it, and then you're gonna come in and like that same script. Da 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 da. Okay, I got it. I'm not gonna say. Cool. That's our script. Yeah. That's our scene. Cool. Okay. So now I want you all to look at the scene, and if somebody has an idea about what Joel could be doing to if you have an idea of what Joel could be doing at any one of these points between the professor and between the his boss to help his situation. That's me. Yeah. What does it say?
It's parents.
Oh, it's my mom. Can you pick up and just tell her on the workshop? It's my mom. She just retired now. She's home now. She's calling me. I love it. Okay, good. Perfect. Good. And remember the solution. So this is what we're going to do, friends. We're going to go back and you're going to do the exact scene. A little bit shorter so we have time for solutions. If you all see a point that you think, okay, I know what he could do. I know what he could say. That might change the events, right? Give him some opportunity. I want you to say stop, and then I'm gonna invite you to talk to me about it. Okay, talk to me about it. Joel, would you mind the people that are coming in using your hoodie?
Using my hoodie.
After you're done. All right. So then, no. You know what? What we're gonna do is we're gonna use my scarf. We're gonna use my scarf. Wearing my tie. Oh, thank you. My scarf is like orange, it's right behind his head. Perfect. Cool.
Thank you.
So we're
going to
do the same scene again. Okay? And the protagonist is going to be rocking this really stylish scarf. Okay. Ready? Same thing again. You're gonna go first. It's the same scene, just a little shorter. And then on the lookout for stop, okay? So now, of course, we can't begin without the magic cues of 3, 2, 1, action, and we're all gonna start the magic theater. Ready?
Three, two, one, action!
Well, you have to study hard. Senior exams are not very well. It's not even close to a 70. That's the worst part. I don't know, but I expect you to study hard. I expect you to, whatever you're doing after class, stop what you're doing and just start studying. If you want to get into, because I heard you really want to go to medical school, you must go to medical school. You need to increase your grades, at least A. I want to see an A in the next exam. I don't see an A in the next exam, you're not going to.
I understand.
Can I get that for you? Yeah?
Yeah, I can definitely do it. I can make more time. I can stop fooling around or better manage my time.
You may have to lose sleep for this too.
Lose sleep?
Yeah.
Okay. I would try my best not to, but yeah. If that's the case, then I have to do it.
Okay, go. Awesome.
Joab, what are you doing?
Oh, I was just
Now, closing my time, okay? So you study on your time. You sleep on your time. My time, you work. Open your eyes and work.
Yes.
Stop. Oh, stop. Okay, very nice. Okay. So tell me your name.
Catherine.
So you wanted to stop. So go back. When they say stop, you freeze. Okay. So now, what? do you think, what do you want to suggest?
Solution, while you're at work, get a tablet, download all your books, because they won't know what you're reading, and you could be studying while you're at work.
Okay, perfect. So, Catherine, this is a great solution. I would like for you to show us. So, can you please take off the scarf? And now, Catherine is going to represent...
I don't agree.
Oh, let me get my tablet. Shut up.
Yeah. Oh. You can just act like you have a tablet, just for time's sake. I want to make sure a few people are. Right. So now we're gonna try several rounds. So now we're gonna try the round with Catherine B. Joel. Ready? So and again and three,
two,
one,
action.
Do you see the line of the customers?
Oh yes, I was just taking a break. I'm getting ready to go get up.
You already took your break, so can you take care of that?
Sure.
Great.
No, after the tablet.
I closed it. As soon as I seen her shadow behind me, I closed it.
Okay. So what happened?
It kind of worked though.
Yeah, it depends on what kind of work.
Did you get some work done?
I'm a home help aide. Remember how I told you how the patient want to act crazy? But some people, when I'm at a 12-hour case, you have plenty of time that you sit down.
Yeah, yeah.
But some people want you to watch TV, just do all kind of stupid stuff. You understand? Yeah. But being that I don't, they used to complain that I'm doing my homework. So I said, buy a tablet. You don't know what I'm reading. You understand? Or watching, and I'm doing my work for school. I know how to shut them up.
Okay, time. So tell me, can this be helpful?
No.
Wait. Can this help everybody purpose or
no?
Not every
driver can.
Yeah, I was about to say, so we were doing this, Joelle had shit situation, right? So her job is totally different from Joel's
exactly,
job. So she can't, because really, Joel has a manager. He has a boss like right there on his her. At her job, she's her own boss. They have to call her boss at the office, like somewhere else. So the only person she really has to listen to is her client. Her client's her boss. So her client can't really. The client's like saying fire because you're the tech. Client's saying, she's going to Jerry. You know, sometimes a different atmosphere is different.
So do we have any, so this, we need to work more, right?
Yeah, because
we need to work more. Do you have an idea of what he might be able to do? Do you want to come into this?
I don't have an idea
of somebody
who
will have to act.
I'll act with you, and I want to see your
idea. No, I will be the boss. I'm like, you have an idea? Isn't this moment?
You want
to
be
special. Okay, perfect. So we're going to do it. So let's ready. So from what moment?
At work.
And what was the last thing that she might say? What's her line?
Okay.
She thought of a way to compromise with her employer to figure out how to get some time.
To work right? for both.
Can this possibly happen?
Yes. I'm
not saying it's gonna work. It's not about that. But it is a strategy that could possibly happen. Very nice.
However.
Not every situation, but okay. So nice. Well, we're putting ideas in our bank, right? We're like bop, 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 bop. However, do we have any other ideas? Or do we want to go to another scene, right? Alright, let's give a round of applause. Yeah. Now, how did I get? Is somebody acting in? Oh, you have
work study.
Oh, not yet. Oh, all right. Ready? So now, tell us what time. Well, you can do a part-time, that's no problem with me, just I need you on the busy times. Like, right now, I need you to work, and I can cut you hours.
Okay. After today, I'm probably going to need to do that.
Alright, so come see me after the
month.
Thank
you, sir.
Once
you're
done.
Okay.
Interesting. Okay.
Just as much as this class and school. If there's a way that I can meet with you at another time, maybe during your office hours, I can, maybe that same time that you're studying, I can spend more. I would spend that time studying with you or asking questions.
Okay, before that, do you know my office hours exactly?
I do not.
Oh, okay, I'm just asking because I'm going to make sure you know. It's on Monday before class.
Okay.
Before class. So you can come into my office hours. We can discuss a lot of things, even before exams. But when you take that exam, I can't help it right there.
Yeah. Well, if I have your assistance, I can guarantee that you're going to see, through my effort, you're going to see a higher grade.
Okay.
Stop.
I
want to hear
from you guys. Hey, okay.
Woo!
Okay. What was
the
last sentence you said? I said it's the bathroom. And just to tip for actors, don't turn your back to the audience.
Yes.
You also have audience over here. So let's, yeah, let you cheat. You go
see you work.
Like this. Right? Yeah, nice. There you go.
Come on,
confess.
All right. Icy. All right, you haven't been studying lately, and I gave you my office hours. Have you been studying?
I have been studying, but I believe that if this class is too much for me, I may have to withdraw.
Withdraw?
I'll take you next semester.
I'll take the next semester.
Because if this is too much for me, I'd rather leave now and do a better time next time.
Better time next time.
Stop.
Stop. Hold on.
Okay, and...
Okay.
What was the strategy?
She said she's gonna withdraw.
Can this be helpful?
No.
Okay, hold on.
Depending on what time of the year.
Okay.
How many classes do you guys?
Because there are penalties.
But the reality is,
withdrawal is no, my brother.
Hold on, we gotta let people, you know, all of us.
I had five classes. I had to withdraw from a class that was too hard. I'd rather withdraw than get an F. And
a W
is easier than an F to get rid of.
Both of them suck.
No,
my opinion.
Hold on, we can't do it like that.
Okay.
Can't do it like that. We need to.
For financial aid, you need to be
Let people talk and finish their sentence. And then we gotta figure out raising our hands or something so that a lot of people can talk, because a lot of people have opinions, okay? So, tell us, withdrawing has been helpful for you?
Yes.
Why?
Because if I'm failing a class that I know I can't study for, but I'm doing good in my other classes, I can sacrifice that class and take it another time, which is what I've done. Being a full-time student, I only take 4 classes instead of 5. That gives me an extra semester, but I get good grades. I have straight A's for 3 semesters. So that helps me.
Okay.
I understand.
Everyone is there? Okay.
Yeah.
She's talking about what helped her.
I understand.
That's some real stuff, right? So thank you. Okay. Thank you. So let's give her a round of applause. So hold on a bit. So good. Thank you so much. Tell me your name again.
Devaney.
Now, of course this is not going to solve everything. What we're exploring here is ideas. What are the things that can do, that we can do to push, right? And like open that hole to get through, right? It's not all going to happen at once. So I'm looking at the time. You have a question.
A question.
All right, what's your
question? What was our intended target for this whole entire exercise? Because I'm thinking, I was under the impression, I'm sorry, that's why I didn't know.
No, it's not.
But I just was under the impression that we were trying to balance the job in school. I didn't think we were trying to like sacrifice one for the other, or like try to put one. I thought it was like the best solution for us to be able to move forward and be possible. You know what I thought? That's what we were doing. So I'm lost a little bit.
Well, I think that's exactly what she was saying. She's saying by withdrawing a class, she's not sacrificing her whole school.
She's just sacrificing that.
She's playing chess. You understand? She was playing chess. She said, I'm going to give up my pawn in order to advance my knight a couple pieces and be in a more strategic place. That may not work for everybody. But what she's saying is it has worked for her at one particular time, so maybe that's something we can put in our toolbox, right, when we're talking about balancing. Now, we have other things that we can explore, right, about how to talk to the professor, how to talk to the cashier.
To the manager.
And so now, because we're running short, like, on time, I want to give give opportunity for some people to also contribute that haven't had a chance. So would you mind telling
us today? What I was saying, it depends on the time of what time during the semester that you want to secure, because some people don't realize the struggle is way in the middle, almost to the end of the English. But I had that problem with English and I ended up with a B plus because I was getting the straight A's. And I have one B plus on my thing, and it was my English because I was very struggling on that one because they started a new program from Columbia University. And we was the guinea pig group for that one. And we had to do 5 books in one, and that was a very short semester because we had a lot of holidays and stuff in between the fall. That was the fall semester. And we was a pilot group for that project. And it was very, very, very stressful. In the end, I just wanted it to be over. And I sacrificed my A for a B plus because I should have rewritten one paper. And I couldn't. I was at my breaking point.
Okay.
So it depends on where in the semester for you to withdraw to the end of the semester. Your faith. That's for the end. That's the pleasure. But she might have done it in the early part of the semester. That time it will work. But if it's after that.
Okay. So I'm hearing another experience of it does depend on what time. If it's earlier, there's a certain timing. It may be helpful, but after a certain timing, it wouldn't work. And so in that timing, we would need to explore another option, right? So the way that this goes is like there are other players, right? Maybe their life is not, Joelle's life is not just the teachers or not just the cashier. But are there other people that could be brought upon as allies to help him balance? Right? Possibly. Family. What? Who else could possibly help? Other professors. Who else?
The counseling over here.
Counselors.
One of the aspects is time management.
Thank you, counselors here, tutors, advisors. Cool. So.
Co-workers.
Okay. So maybe you would do a scene where you ask a co-worker to take some shifts for you. That way you're not losing your job. Excellent. So the idea here is we're beginning to build on something, right?
Yes.
And I want to share this tool with you because just in the way that we created this right here, you guys could maybe when you have a meeting, be like, all right, let's form theater a personal life issue. Let's form theater somebody that has some kind of, like I shared my brother is struggling with drugs. Like I would love to share that and say like, what are other ways that people have helped and supported? So the idea is here, we're just beginning things, you know what I mean? Like I want you to be able to have this tool of playing, of theater making, but also being able to utilize play to practice for change. Augusto Boal used to call foreign theater the rehearsal for the revolution. Because literally they would create all of these circumstances and start like playing them. And just in the way that I love it, you're like, nope, that wouldn't work. Because in real life, this would happen. Or, well, that might help a little circumstance, but no sé qué, right? That's the form there. That's magical. Because obviously Joel could have been like, can I just get a raise and a lot of shifts? Yes, sure. And then that could be the play. But would that happen?
No.
That's magic. You know what I mean? So that's the tool. And that's our time. And I would love to have time for us to all circle up and close the space together. Yeah?
Yeah.
Give yourself a round of applause.
I was waiting on you, bro.
Something that we're gonna leave with. If you could sum it in one word, that would be ideal. Yes.
Your roles, right, whether it's student, employee, leader, follower, whatever the situation you're in, you have to understand that the tough conversations that you're going to have are not going to play out the way that you think they're going to play out. So prepping in some way for dealing with those situations actually makes you a more effective leader. I'm from the theater background, right? I make no bones about it. That's what I got my theater, it's my master's is in theater at Columbia, writing. So I believe in this as a process. Because I've seen leaders who communicate with each other on a regular basis who basically think that they're always right and And then the next guy who thinks he's a leader too, or thinks she's a leader too, is always right. And it ends up in conversations that don't resolve anything, except giving everybody a headache, especially the people who are listening to those conversations, who say, they're not right anyway, so I'm not going to listen to them. When you are able to exercise, to use the tool, to get into a forum of discussion, and we'll do more workshops with Vivia throughout the semester, it allows you to play out the role, to get a sense of the different perspectives, and to sort of play around with the ideas of, you know what, I may not be looking at this the right way. So even though one person may see it one way, another person may see it the other way, doesn't mean that either way is wrong. But it is important that you show each other, share with each other, so that you get to the point of like, an actual conversation is gonna happen. In the time that you guys been doing the workshop, I've done 4 or 5 different conversations that I've had to have with different people who think that they're right, and I think that they're doing the right thing, and I've got to just like tell them, you know what, maybe you're not. And that's my role, to come to you as you go along your journey to sort of give you guidance and support. But the reason why we do this, the reason why I love Namibia, the reason why we do these types of workshops is so that you can get have that experience as well. But it actually helps you. It really does. You may not see it right now, and we'll probably have to do a couple more in the semester to see if it actually works better. But when you put into these situations, when you're flexing your mind around different ideas and perspectives, all of a sudden you're looking at the problem in a different light. So thank you, Namibia, for being here. I want to say something about yesterday, by the way. Can I say something about
yesterday? Yes, sure.
You guys beat me up yesterday about not having breaks.
Yeah!
Oh, oh, you know what? I got up at 5:30 this morning. I took my 18-month-old to daycare and brought my wife to work. I have not even had a bathroom break today. I'm solving people's problems who graduated in 2010. Gabriel needed need paper. I gotta get it. I got other people over here. I gotta make sure food gets to you guys. I'm making sure we got heat in the room. We got flooding going on in the whole room. I'm taking a break yet. So I understand. But my vision for the thing, this project that we do this, you have the right to move around and leave and come as you go. I wanna have the moment, that the short little period of time that we share together, to give you as much information as possible. And I will squeeze it into the best of my ability. Why? Because from my perspective, it's an opportunity.